Welcome everyone to the third episode of Azure Security Center in the Field. Thank you very much for the overwhelm response to the first two episodes. We are growing our followers and I appreciate all the feedback. Today we are going to talk about vulnerability assessment in Azure Security Center, and to describe how this functionality works, we have a very special guest from our engineer team in Israel, Aviv Moore. Aviv, thank you very much for your time. Thanks for being here today.
Hi, Yuri. Thanks for having me. It's great to be here.
So, Aviv, can you please describe what you do for Microsoft? What are your current role and some of the projects that you are working on right now?
Yeah, sure. I'm part of the Azure Security Center product management team. My team deals with the CWP, cloud workload protection, and my area of responsibility is mainly around server security or VM security. So I'm responsible for features like the vulnerability assessment that we're going to talk about today, and also JIT, just-in-time access, and several more. So that's it. Very happy to be here today.
Excellent. So the vulnerability assessment is one of the functionalities that a lot of customers there have been using recently, because it really helps not only to identify vulnerabilities in ISVM's workloads, but also helps a lot of blue teams to better understand their current secure posture on those workloads. With that, can you give a brief explanation about how this feature works, the partnership with Qualys, and how we are packaging this solution in Azure Security Center?
Yeah, sure. So basically, the idea here was to bring vulnerability assessment capabilities that are streamlined and built in into ASC. It's an important part for reducing the attack surface that attackers can use. For that, we partnered up with Qualys, which is a market leader for vulnerability assessments. And we are basically using their engine for collecting the artifacts and analyzing them for finding vulnerabilities. But we've took that engine and we've integrated it deeply into ASC. So the whole experience and receiving the findings and analyzing them can be done within ASC. So I will briefly explain how that works. It starts with ASC trying to determine whether your resources or VMs more specifically have a vulnerability assessment solution on them. So the first thing that happens is that you will get a recommendation that basically invites you to provision a VA solution onto your VMs. By the way, we have vulnerability assessment for other types of resources as well, such as SQL Server and also Container Registry, but we're not going to talk about them today. We're going to talk about servers. And so the first thing that happens is that recommendation. And in order to remediate it, you basically have to provision your own VA solution of choice. There is the built-in solution, which is part of the ASC standard tier. So it's included within that with no additional cost. But you can also bring your own license if you have a license from one of the companies, such as Qualys or Rapid7. So with the built-in solution, you can easily provision a VA agent onto your machines. This is what we call a quick fix. We're going to see that in the demo, in which you can, with minimal effort, provision that agent. So that's step number one. The next thing that's going to happen is that the agent is going to be deployed onto your machines. Usually it takes a couple of minutes for provisioning it to a machine. And from that point, it will scan every 4 hours. And it will collect artifacts from the machine and send them for analysis. The types of artifacts that are being collected at each scan are primarily registry keys, installed software, and their versions, operating system configurations, and different artifacts. And it's being sent securely into Qualys for analysis, and then they send back to ASC the findings and the vulnerabilities that were found onto that machine. So that process takes place every few hours. So it's near real-time analysis of vulnerabilities. And at this point, basically, you get into the ASC UI, all the findings, all the vulnerabilities that were discovered on your machines. And at that point, you can analyze them either manually through the GUI or programmatically, which we can elaborate more on later, and decide on how you want to remediate it.
When you say that the findings are sent into Qualys Cloud to verify, there are any type of specific access that you need to have, is pure HTTPS over the internet? There is any IP address that needs to be filtered, assuming that, for example, that client is behind a firewall or something?
Yeah. So basically, there's very little configuration that needs to be enabled for that to work. So at the moment, what needs to be done for the agents to be deployed is basically to enable communication from the VMs to certain addresses of Qualys. We use two main data centers of Qualys, depending on the Azure region. So at some level, we allow data sovereignty policies to be supported. And basically, communication to those two addresses, which are detailed in the in our documentation, we will share that link here. So communication to those addresses needs to be enabled, but other than that, there's no special configuration needed. Mm. And I forgot to mention before, there's a wide variety of operating systems supported. Basically, Windows and Linux are supported very widely. And there's also a list of all supported versions or distributions in the documentation as well.
Excellent. All right, so we already know how it works primarily behind the scenes and how all the architecture, the core architecture is. Now, for large organizations that are looking for massive deployment of the agent, while the quick fix is a great solution, what if I want to deploy in scale for many VMs at the same time? Do we have any ARM template support for that? How customers can approach this scenario?
Yeah, so that's a very good question and obviously a common use case. So although you can decide manually on specific VMs and then remediate them through the UI, you can also do that programmatically using the ASC API. And also a third option is to use ARM templates in order to include automatically the extension for the built-in VA to be deployed on each of your machines. So you can choose from either options according to the need.
Excellent. One other question that I know is very common for customers to ask is, while the Security Center dashboard shows the results pretty nicely, organized, the secure checks and everything, the machines that were affected by those secure checks, do you have any way to consume that information outside of Security Center to export or something?
Yeah, that's also something that we see commonly being asked and also used by customers. So I think the main use cases are taking that data and exporting it to a SIEM solution or sending it to a ticketing system. So obviously you can do that. Basically all the VA findings are accessible through ARG as a resource graph. So it's basically there, and you can form your own query and basically slice and dice the data the way that fits you. You also wrote a very good blog post on that with an example. So there are resources out there that basically show you how to do that. And we see a lot of customers using that.
Aviv, that was, I think that was a great intro, but people like to see things working. So if you could show us a demo, that would be great.
Sure. So this is the overview screen of Azure Security Center. We can start with looking at the recommendations. And on the top, we have recommendations around vulnerability assessment. So the first part that we talked about provisioning agents to unprotected VMs, is actually this recommendation where we said we have a quick fix on. So I'm going to click on that. And now I can simply see what VMs are unprotected, and I am recommended to provision an agent to them. On the other list, we can see VMs that are already being provisioned. So remediating this is as simple as choosing VMs and clicking remediate. We're now using the built-in security solution. So basically, within ASC standard tier, you have this included within the license with at no additional cost. So that's one nice benefit of this feature. And to remediate that, we just have to click, and then within a few minutes, we should have an agent up and running on those VMs. Now, when we spoke about doing that at scale and using ARM templates for that, we can simply copy and paste this remediation logic into our ARM templates. So that's the second part. So this is basically how you provision built-in VA agents onto your VMs. Now we'll go to the second recommendation. And this is for the step after, in which we already have VMs monitored. I forgot to mention, but the agent basically collects artifacts and does the vulnerability scanning every 4 hours. So it's pretty much near real time for seeing vulnerabilities in your environment. So now we're looking on the vulnerability findings. We can see the VMs affected by them. And this is basically one way to look at it. This is the an overview of all the vulnerabilities in our monitored VMs, and it shows us, it's basically sorted by severity, and it shows us to how many VMs a certain vulnerability applies to. To dive in what we can see on every vulnerability, I'm going to pick an example here. So we seem to have Putty installed in the environment. So when we open one of the vulnerabilities, we have rich data around it, so we can see the CVSS base scores, we can see related CVEs. We get an explanation on the nature of that threat, so basically what an attacker can do with that. Of course, how to remediate, and all the VMs affected. In this example, it's only one VM affected. And from here we can do basically another thing, and we can pivot on that specific VM. So clicking on one VM sorts the data differently, and we can see all the vulnerabilities of that VM again sorted by severity.
Oh, that's great. So that's great because you can pivot for the VM and then see all vulnerabilities that are currently open for that VM.
Exactly. And then for each of them, get into the details. So that's basically it for getting the findings of the results of all the scannings. That specific data, what I'm showing you here, is what is available for us to query from ARG, where we can later on slice and dice it the way that we want, and then export it to other platforms. So that's a quick demo of provisioning our built-in VA solution into VMs, and then getting the findings back.
Excellent.
Yeah.
No, that was very good. I like the experience. I like the fact that you can pivot the VM itself to see the current vulnerabilities that are open to that VM. So that was really good. And the fact that you can use ARG, Azure Resource Graph, to export that information is also something extremely rich. Now, to wrap up this show and also the topic, do you have any final considerations, recommendations, best practices for our listeners that are interested in deploying this capability?
So basically, it's pretty straightforward, this feature. So I want to invite users to basically try it. and experience it. We're going to post in the video the documentation for how to get started with using the VA. Also, another link that we'll be posting will be the link to our community. So we are very very eager to get feedback from users so we can continuously improve this feature.
Excellent. So the GitHub community that we've been talking about in almost every single episode is the location where we have scripts, automations, and you can also contribute. If you build an automation, you can contribute with that. We have a workbook, actually, that was created by one of our colleagues here at Microsoft, Carlos, and this workbook allows you to see the Qualys vulnerabilities into a single place as well. So there's a lot of flexibility on that, and there's a lot of lessons learned that people are putting into this GitHub community. So that's really good. Aviv, thanks again for your time, for your participation, being able to join to episode 3 and explain about the vulnerability assessment integration with Qualys. I truly appreciate your time.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you, Yuri, for having me.
Absolutely. And that's a wrap for episode 3. Continue to watch our episodes. Make sure to subscribe to our new Microsoft Security channel. And make sure that you are enabling notifications about the new videos. Every 2 weeks, we have a new episode about a specific capability in Azure Security Center. Thank you very much for your time, and see you next time.